And now we will learn one way to import transactions from QuickBooks Desktop to QuickBooks Online. Using the Export Company File to QuickBooks Online command, which is in the main menu of the QuickBooks Desktop software, we're able to export all the information from your QuickBooks Desktop file to your QuickBooks Online account. It transfers the data from the desktop version to the online version, and it's so easy. You just click from the main menu. Then after you do that, QuickBooks will ask you for your username and password for QuickBooks Online. After you put in the username and password, you will get a message asking you to wait for an email. After you get the email, you can log in to your QuickBooks Online and you can see everything that was in your QuickBooks Desktop file is now in your QuickBooks Online account. Sounds great, right? However, there are some things you must be aware of. Everything in the QuickBooks Online account that was there before you uploaded your desktop information, everything that was there that was not in the desktop will be erased. The desktop will overwrite everything in the file, and that includes transactions, list items such as customers, vendors, and products. Memorized reports will not transfer from the desktop version to the online version, and if you made custom reports in QuickBooks Online, they're going to disappear after you do this procedure. In fact, all of the account settings and preferences that you set up in QuickBooks Online will also go back to the defaults, and any preferences that you might have had are not going to transfer. And since there is no icon bar, you know, nothing from the icon bar will transfer because there is no icon bar. So read carefully number 4. Memorized transactions, memorized reports, anything in the icon bar, and anything in the preferences will not transfer. It's almost like it'll be a brand new company overwritten with whatever happened to be in the QuickBooks file at the moment that you did the transfer. So here we are in the QuickBooks Online account for the very large corporation of America. Now, before we upload, I want to prove to you this file or this online account is empty. When I click reports and I click trial balance, you will see nothing. Even if I include all dates and run the report, you will see this file has nothing. If I click sales and go to the customer list, there are no customers. If I click expenses and I go to the vendor list, there are no vendors. You get the point. Now watch. When I go back to my QuickBooks Desktop account for the same company, the very large corporation of America, it's very simple. Click company, and the very last choice is export to company file to QuickBooks Online. That's all you have to click. Then just wait a few seconds and QuickBooks will ask you your login information for that particular QuickBooks Online company account. Okay, so I'm going to use the email account that I created with this. Okay, and I'm going to put, see if it works, and log right in. Okay, now start fresh and see they're warning you. Start by choosing which particular company you're importing to. Well, in my case, in your case, there'll only be one. This one, the one you just saw. Once you choose that company, you click continue. Now it could take up to 30 minutes, and what they do is they tell you where on it. We're transferring your data. When it's done, we'll send you a confirmation email. Now, the email comes pretty quickly. I'm very impressed. It usually comes a lot faster than a half hour. I'm going to click OK, got it. Now, I suspect that the email comes more quickly than we imagine. So I'm going to go over to my Gmail account. Oh, look at this, 1:13 p.m., which is the time that I'm doing this. So look at this. Don't reply. It's already available. 1, 2, 3. Look at that. See? So when, oh, well, okay. Anyway, when I double click the email that I got, it says, congratulations, your stuff is online. Blah, 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 blah. Now, when we come back to the company and we click dashboard, you see that we now have expenses and income. And if I click reports again, and I head over to the trial balance, you can see the trial balance now has results of transactions. But you may well ask, why would someone do this more than once? Well, you could use your desktop version of QuickBooks for the data entry, and you can upload daily so that you can see reports and access transactions from remote locations. So that's something to think about if you want to have both desktop and QuickBooks Online, and you really only need the online version so that you can see transactions from anywhere and you could read reports from anywhere. And then this way you have the benefit of both desktop features as well as online features.